Hello guys, welcome back once again to the channel Get It Quickly. This is ongoing series on Notepad++ and today we are gonna learn how we can search or find any of the word in the text editor, right? So we have left this in our previous video in which we actually learned like how we can edit multiple lines in our Notepad++ or how we can copy like a partial piece of our text from multiple lines and how we can paste it, like how does it affect the already existing line if we kind of, you know, not trying to mess it up, right? So in today's video, as I mentioned, we are gonna learn like how we can find or search a text in our file. Okay, so to do this experiment, I'm gonna go in the new file and I kind of stole a piece of C code from a random website and I have copied it already. So it is in my clipboard. I'm just gonna paste it here. So before we actually find any of the word, I wanna make sure like I should cover this orange or green line concept that we have left before, right? So the thing is, like, to understand this thing, basically what I'm gonna do is like I'm gonna save this file right now so that you can understand, like, once I save this file, this line will be green. Okay, so just let's save it, right? Type sample.c. all right, then you can see like that line that was orange, now it is green because now everything in the single line, it is saved. And you know the purpose of saving this file, because you can also feel the syntax of that C code, like all of the keywords, they become colored. Okay, so now the question here is like, if I am gonna edit any of the file, like if I just type like a comment, I am making a comment here. And now you can see like these two lines, they become orange. That actually represent like I do have some kind of change here, which is not saved yet. So you can also see like that color is also changed to red or orange, whatever you want to say. And these two lines, basically that represent the color of these lines, that represent like these two lines are changed. Okay, so if I'm just gonna hit like Control S, this color will gone again and this color will, you know, change it to light blue, which means like the file is now saved. Okay, so that was the concept that we left before, so we just covered. Now the actual thing we are gonna do is like, for example, I'm gonna search the word flag right here. So I'm gonna double click on this word flag and then I'm just gonna hit Control F from my keyboard and then it's gonna pop up a new window called find. And you notice here like the word I kind of highlighted flag, this word automatically comes up here in find what. Okay, so the thing is like now we can find that word, like how many times this word actually comes up in our file. So right now you can notice here is like at line number 5, this line is all highlighted because this find dialog box, it points out the first instance right now. Okay, so what if I click find next? You can see now line 10 is highlighted because now that points out like this is basically the second instance of the word flag, and that's how we can do like for other instances, right? So you can also see like there is a checkbox just right side of the find next button. What happens if I click this guy, right? So just click it and then you can see like now we do have like two arrows, one directs to upward and one directs to downward. So this button is basically is just gonna do the same that it was doing before, but this guy is actually gonna do the opposite of what it does, right? So for example, if I click this guy, it will actually go upward. Okay, so this is a cool feature, right? And you can also like do the same thing instead of doing here. What I can do is like, what if I check this backward direction, it's gonna go in the same, like if I click right now find next is gonna go down, but if I click this backward direction, it's gonna go up again. Okay, so this is one thing. Let's talk about these four features here. So the first one we already covered, right? The last one is basically wraparound, which means like if I'm gonna do this guy, so you can see like this will actually go back here and it starts doing the same thing. So it's more like the wrapping thing or loop type of thing, right? If I just uncheck this guy, then it's gonna do this, and then it will say find, can't find the next flag, because right now I do have backward direction selected. That's why it's trying to go upward, but it's not, because you know there is no wraparound function enabled right now. Okay, so by default it is enabled, so we can keep this guy enabled. The other two guys are match case and match whole word only. So to understand these functionalities, first we are gonna look this match whole word only thing, right? So I'm gonna check this guy and then I'm gonna find this, and you can see like, oh, there's no, I just unchecked the backward direction, and you see like there is no change here, right? Because I have just match whole word only and it is doing the same thing, right? But for example, if I'm gonna type here like another comment like flags, right, instead of flag, okay? So the thing is like flags, it does have S with flag and it should find flag in the word flags, right? But it's not gonna do this, you see? But what if I unselect this guy and then I select match case? So it will now find out the flag word in the word flags, right? Let's see if it actually happens. See, it doesn't highlight the word flag like the other instances, but it actually find that instance like this happens, the word flag in the word flags, right? So this is the difference of match case and match whole word only, right? And we can also take like another example, like take N as a find word and then hit Control F again, and then it will automatically come to the find what field, and then we can try finding it out, like find next. Okay, it is finding right now because I do have this match case enabled, right? And then if I uncheck it and check this guy, it will only find the unique N's. Right now it's not gonna find the other instances of N. But if I uncheck this one as well, then it's gonna do like for all N's by default, like the unique N's and the other instances of N wherever it just, you know, shows up in any of the word. See, N is in the not. So this is the difference. So we covered all that four features. Now we are gonna see search mode. So we do have like three options here: normal, extended, and regular expressions, right? So by default, we do have normal, which means like everything is normal, right? I mean, it's just the default mode. But the extended mode, and in the brackets, it does say like it can also find the characters that we actually don't see in our text file, but they are there, like the next line or the carriage return or the tab or whatever the extended characters are. So if I will try to find out right now like backslash n, it will not find anything, right? It just says find, cannot find the text backslash n. But what if I select the search mode extended, and now you can see like it will actually finding out the new line character, right? So you can see like it is actually pointing me like the space, which means like there is backslash n at the end of the line, right? And if there is like a slash r, it will give you slash r just by showing the space type of thing. See, and the regular expression is more like an advanced feature, and we will discuss this guy later on. On this side, we do have like transparency, and it's nothing to have with find feature. Basically, it is this Windows properties, I should say. If I do this guy like uncheck, and if I click here, you can see like this Windows is still more like the same when it was active, right? But if I check this guy transparency, and then if I go back here, you can notice a change, right? I mean, the find window is basically, it becomes transparent, and that's, as I said, like it's more like the window property instead of the searching feature. And you can also, you know, play around like it always or focus and what kind of transparency you want it to be, right? If I do this, it will be really transparent, right? You can even see, right? So this is how we can select this feature. Now let's talk about the other features we have in the Find window, specifically in the Find tab. So the cool feature we have here is basically the drop-down history, like whatever we have already tried to find the words, right? For example, we tried three things, flag, n, and backslash n. So you can, you know, from here, you can also select if you really want to go back to find something that you already tried to find out, okay? So I'm going to select word flag, and then I'm going to discuss this feature which is called count. And what it does basically, it actually counts the number of instances of the word that we are looking for. Right now, we are going to look for the word flag, and then we are going to count the number of instances of the word flag. So you can see now we have 8 matches in the entire file, right? And if I'm going to go select this find next thing, what I can see is like I can count it manually like this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7, right? But there is like another instance here, right? It doesn't highlight that word, but it actually counts it. Why? Because I didn't specify the match whole word only. So if I'm gonna select this guy and then I will count it again, now it will say 7 matches, right? So another thing we can do, you can also notice like there is like a rectangular here and then it says in selection. So we can select like particular text and then we can count the number of instances in that selection. For example, if I'm gonna select only this part and then I'm gonna go here and then in selection I'm gonna count it, then it will say just two instances, like this guy and another one is this guy, right? So the other option we have here is find all in current document, which is more like the same thing. So what I'm going to do here is basically I'm going to uncheck this in selection, and what I'm going to do here is basically click this guy, find all in current document, and see what happens. So basically it did the same. Instead of highlighting like every single instance, it basically lists out all of the lines wherever that flag instance happened, okay? So what I'm gonna do right now is basically clear this guy, clear all, because if I don't do it, next time if I'll do the same thing, it will basically accumulate all the results, right? So clear all, because I'm gonna show you the next trick, which is Control F and this feature, find all in all opened documents. So if I do it right now, it will give me basically the exact same result that we have before, right? So I will do it again, like clear all. And then in the new one, what I'm going to do here is type flag and then go back here and hit Control F and then hit find all in all open documents button. And you can see now it actually listed out all of the instances in all of the open file, right? So it says like line number 12 in new one document, one hit, and here is the 7 hit, right? So this is like another cool feature. So that's it for this video. In the next video, we are gonna learn like how we can replace a word, like all of them together or whatever features we have. So I hope you enjoyed this video. Please subscribe the channel so that we can keep continue our journey to learn Notepad++. And if you have any suggestions or questions or comments, please let me know in the comment sections so I can improve the quality of the contents, and I will appreciate all your comments and suggestions. Thanks for watching.